Bàbá dáadáa, bàbá rere, bá Amos bo délé òkílé. Bó dọ̀rùn o ṣọ̀run re. Ẹ̀wọ́ wa kíkọjú ọkùnrin, ẹ̀wọ́ wo ránṣẹ́ Ọlọ́run alàyè, ẹ̀wọ́ wo bàbá dáadáa, ẹ̀wọ́ wo ọkọ rere. Bàbá o, o ṣe okú ọmọ ṣe, iwájú tó kọjú sí òní bàjẹ́ lọ́lá Ọlọ́run ọba. Ẹ̀yìn tẹ́ wá fi sílẹ̀ onídàrú lọ́lá Ọlọ́run ọba. Gbogbo ẹbí, ọmọ, ọmọ, aya, pátápátá ná ṣe léde láyìn ra o bàbá dáadáa. Àwọn ọmọ wípé dáadéle àkí ilé o. Àkòyà ibi gbogbo ọmọ àtọmọmọ lọ́lá Ọlọ́run Edumàrè. Bẹ̀bá ti ń wo wájú ire ni, bẹ̀bá ti ń wá ire ni, bẹ̀bá wọ̀ tún ire ni, bẹ̀bá wọ̀ òkè ire ni, bẹ̀bá wọ̀ là ire ni. Mo sún mọ́ bá níwọ̀n ẹgbẹ̀fà, mo jìnà sọ́ba níwọ̀n egbèje, mo tẹ̀rí bá níwá ju ọba.
itana to bope lasa to tutu yoyo be nigba doje basiko asubu asironi apere yi funra wa ni bọlọrun ti wi omode ataka ma po o ko ni gbagbo gogo agbaye e ma po o ki gbogbo ni ton jo ki gbogbo ni ton jado ma po o ka ma mo wi pe yepere ni wa bi eweko o jare
iya banjaru iya ban fi to ewure je ka o ama gbagbe pe ati ko ma je laye o iya banjia iya ban mu iya ban mu mi o ti wa
ba ba mo se je ku le shoshi lo
ama gbagbe pe ati ko ma je laye o Iya bambu ni ojula musa. Kama gbagbe pe
Good morning, County Friends. Getting close to the time for our service to start. And while we have your undivided attention, we ask that you take a moment, check any electronic device, put them in all vibrate silent mode so it will not interfere with the service. At this time, we'd like to call for the immediate family to come to spend the last quiet moment with their loved one before the casket is closed and we enter into our service. At this time, the immediate family can come forward.
Lord.
Hallelujah.
Once again, I want to appreciate each and every one of us Like we started yesterday, we are no morning Baba. We are celebrating Baba. So we are going to go into praise and worship now, but I want you to do something special for me. As my sisters will be leading the praise, I want us to go around, shake. Brothers should hug brothers, sisters should hug sister. Brothers should shake sister. Please, you can hug Mama, you know, just to encourage and to uplift. So please, I just don't want us to sit and just, but I want us to move around, rejoice in the presence of the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Are we still sitting down? Please let's be on our feet as we worship the King of Glory, the Lord of God. Let's thank Him. Let's worship Him. He is the one that has made it possible for us to be standing here today. If not for God, where can we be? Let's appreciate God. Baba has spent a great life. We appreciate his life. Everybody testified yesterday. If you were there, you would know how grateful Baba was. So let's be in a happy mood. Okay? Baba is with God. He's with Christ. He's rejoicing over there. As my pastor just said, please let's hug Mama, hug ourselves, and let's celebrate the life of our Father. Let's worship the King of Glory. Let's give him the glory. Let's worship him. Let's say thank you, Jesus, for everything you have done. How excellent is your name, O Lord. How excellent is your name.
Oh,
church, I will encourage all of us to please rise as we take the first thing before the angels.
Such as the voice of an angel, breathing a blessing on her, hope with a gentle persuasion, whispers a comforting word. Wait till the darkness is over. Wait till the tempest is down. Hope for the sunshine tomorrow. After the darkness is gone.
From 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13 to 18. But I will not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others that have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with his words. May the Lord bless the reading of his word. So we have the eulogy on the program, but I'm going to seek your indulgence, to speak from the heart. From the time the child is born to the time the child returns back to God, there are many phases of life. A child might be a son or might be a daughter. Then they grow up, they become a student. One day, a child might be a husband or a wife. As they grow, they begin to walk. They make impact on people. The way they live, the way a child has lived his life over a period of time, when they become adult, will determine how their story is written. So I'm going to take the story of my dad from when he was a child up to the way, to the time he was 84, almost 85, when he passed away. How he lived his life, and what we can benefit from him, what we learn from him. He was born to the Amondini family in Filiti. It's a traditional worshiper, His dad was a Methodist, so he grew up being a Methodist, but, at the same time, the family has what I call obligations to the priesthood of the town. He grew up as a Methodist because his father was a Methodist, and they imbibed in him the word of the Lord, and that made a difference in his life. He was born in the church. From the time he grew up to become a student, he went to Methodist primary school. He couldn't afford to go to secondary school, but he went to modern today as they call it. But he was an excellent student. His dad didn't have money because he took him when my dad was, a teenager, and he passed away, so my dad started working. So as a teenager, he took care of his dad, and he excelled. From there, he went on, struggled, went back to university. He was first admitted to University of Lagos, and after 1 year, he dropped out. it was the Spirit of God in him, because he picked it back up 1 year later when he went to University of Ibadan and studied political science with Obafemi Awolowo's scholarship. He then met my mom and they got married. So he became her husband. And soon they had us, he became a father. Some people wish for money. Some people pray for different things. But if I have to wish for anything, this life, next life, will be my dad. He instilled confidence in us. He brought us up in the way of God. I saw him at the highest moment, the lowest moment. He was an educator. And you guys know him in church. But he was also a politician. I don't know if you guys know that part. Yes, he was a politician. He contested in 1990. And he lost the election badly. Badly. And that was the weakest moment in our family. And I learned from him that courage from God. How he rose up from that. It's just a special grace. He was a dedicated educator. He taught from 1970 until 1990 when he retired. But after that, he was still contributing. I remember 2011 when they were coming to US. And I went to Nigeria. I said, "Daddy, it's time to go to the US." He said, "No, how, why, I'm going to work." He was our wife. I think chief examiner or something like that. He got all the way to the top. And he was even committed to that. And he was ready to do that instead of coming to the US. It was a talk of war. I had to tell my mom, "We need to talk to daddy. It's time to let go." And he came to US when he was almost 73. Not as vibrant and strong as he used to be. But the church took over. I don't know how to thank you all. At times when we come and we see them, the way you guys have treated them, it's just unimaginable. We can't believe it. You have done so much. But I believe the short time you met him, you know what daddy was all about. His courage, his belief in God was unshakable. I said something yesterday that he had only one weakness. And that one weakness was he took that commandment, love thy neighbor. He took it to the extreme that he can go to any length to help people. He could do anything to help people. And that will learn from him. If he didn't have much, but what he had, he shared with everybody. It's a special blessing to all of us. And as he goes on today, there's nothing that we want to take away from God and to return all glory to God. To live the wonderful life. This is the celebration of life. And I pray that. I will continue to uphold his legacy. I wish I could be strong as he was to his father, but I will try. My dad was so dedicated to his dad, he only had one more. And that we were planning before he departed. He wanted to go back home and rebuild his burial ground. That was how he was educated at 80. He was talking about that, doing that for his time. So he lived his part, he fulfilled his obligation, he returned back to his maker, and we will continue the legacy. Rest on that.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It is our prayer that the good Lord will continue to uphold our brother and the rest of the children. We also continue to pray for the family, our friends, and pray that the Lord will continue to strengthen them. And especially Mama, I know you are tired. God will continue to be your help. I cannot pray for you, Mama, but God will pray for you, Mama.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. We are going to take the second name. We don't have the second name in the manifest, or is it typographical error? The in two is the last in. So they're going to help us project the in on the screen. By the time it's ready, we'll rise up. Yeah, things are ready. So the second name is take the name of Jesus.
It will joy and comfort give you. Take it there, wherever you go.
Oh, our sweet, oh,
exactly. I said, we have to be there by 11:30. So it's time for remarks by family and friends. You are going to pardon me. I know, sir. Yesterday, I did it on purpose not to invite Mama. So this morning, I'm going to start with Mama. I'm going just two people because of time. If we don't leave by 11, they'll come and send us out. So this is America, I understand. So I want Mama, do you want to say something? Okay. Yesterday, I deliberately did not ask her, but I have to ask her. Thank you, ma'am. So, just two people, my daddy there has raised his hand. One more person, and I will invite the pastor to give a short exhortation. Okay, sir. Just get ready after. Just 1 minute, sir.
1 minute. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In fact, I just want to say thank you to Baba and Mama. What our brother was saying, in fact, they love their even neighbor more than themselves. As a pastor, I was having an issue. And Mama, with this age, she accommodated me into her own house for that period of a little time. And how did I hear about Baba's past? Nobody told me, because with that gap, I lost contact with Mama. So I was having a reading through the Bible of the year. So sometimes the Bible read himself to me by playing the tape. Exactly 2:22 a.m. in the midnight, I got a trance. Baba appeared to me. I was in their house. And Baba was sitting down. How dare you, do you forsake your mom for all this long? You call this man and this woman your mother, and you never come to check on her. And Mama prepared food. I was about to eat. Then I said, Baba, let's eat now. Mama said, just allow Baba to go and rest because he doesn't eat like that. So when we are, I woke up from that trance. I called Mama more than 500 times. She can deal with this. Mama, was, did Baba come home? Because the trance, I didn't really understand it. I said, but my spirit never rests. Till finally one day, Mama said, I've changed my number, but the person that was using my number said, you have called more than 1,000 times. So I have to forward your number to herself, to Mama. And Mama now called me. I said, Baba has passed. I said, oh my God. Well, he's indeed a man of God. Because for him to come and show himself to someone in different place, in fact, I will keep praying for the family. Mama, you have not lost that. You still have kids. We have boys, men that are there for you to the glory of God. May God bless this family in Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank
you, sir.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I just want to thank God for the life of Baba. Baba is such a wonderful dad. I remember a couple of years back, I came back to spend a little time with them. Baba showed the love. So what Uncle Larry is saying, you know, saying it's the right thing, you know. Thank God for his love. He shows the love. And his wonderful soul will rest in peace.
Amen.
And God will not leave the family.
Amen.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone. I know everybody in this room will have something to say about that. But what I would just encourage each and every one of us, including myself, like the speakers have said or have been saying since yesterday, the memories of Baba will continue to live long and longer in our hearts.
Amen.
For some of us that are adopted sons, Baba was really dear for us. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to invite now Pastor Evans to to give us a short exhortation. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
People of God, I want to especially thank every one of you for finding time to come here today to give this last honor and respect to our daddy that I've come to be with the Lord. For you to leave whatever you're doing and to be here at this time, and on behalf of the family and the church, we really appreciate you and say that God will bless you.
Amen.
Let us pray. Eternal Father and our God, we bless your name. Thank you for this day that you have made. Thank you for life. Thank you for everyone that you have that are gathered here today in your name. Lord, for us to honor and to respect and to remember the wonderful life and legacy that our daddy, who is departed to be with you, has made. I pray that this morning, Lord, you minister to us.
Amen.
And you will comfort us.
Amen.
And Lord, you will encourage each and every one of us.
Amen.
Pray that as many as have come will be blessed.
Amen.
And as many as we hear your word will be blessed by your word.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let us quickly read the book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, reading from verse 13. That is the passage of the Bible that was read before by our brother. And it says, "But I will not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that you sorrow not, even as others which have no hope." Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The word of God says, "You should not sorrow like those that have no hope." Because we are God's children, we are God's people, we have a hope, not just a hope, we have a living hope. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There is a hope that is a dead hope. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
There are some people that believe certain things that are not true. They are putting their hope on false truth. And at the end of time, they will find out that what they have believed and what they have hoped on is false. And that might be too late for them. Praise the Lord. But the Bible says we have a living hope, the hope that can never die. Praise the Lord. And so the word of God said we should not sorrow like people that do not have hope. When we lose our loved ones, just like our daddy lying in the casket, lifeless, he has lived his life. He has lived a good life. He has left a good legacy. He has gone to be with the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
What we are seeing here is no longer here, just his remains. This is dust. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But we have a hope of meeting again. We have a hope of heaven. We have a hope, a living hope of eternal life. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Oh, yeah. You see, one thing that I know about daddy, like everybody have said, this is a man who loves God. He loves the things of God. He loves the people of God. You know, he had walked and retired in Nigeria before he came to this United States. So here, he dedicated the rest of his life on things of God, about God. At his age, you call him at any time for fellowship, or anywhere he's invited, as long as you're ready to come and pick him up, he's ready to go. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
He was so dedicated. And he talks a lot about heaven. He believed in heaven. His prayers is always that God will help us to make heaven.
And I believe that he has made heaven.
Amen.
And I know that right now he's in heaven.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Christians don't die because of Jesus. Daddy had just fallen asleep. And he's with the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Verse 14 said, "For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him." He has slept in Jesus. He believed in Jesus and he has slept in him. The Bible says whether we live or we die, we live in him. We die in him. Hallelujah. God has brought him with Jesus and is with the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
And so that should comfort us. And the question is, for the rest of us that are here, what are we doing also to make sure that we make it? Do we have heaven in focus? Or, because this is America, everybody's talking about work. Everybody's busy. People are doing overtime. And many a times we forget about God and the things of God. It's all about work and business. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bible says, where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. Is your heart in heaven? Is your treasure over there? Or are you preoccupied with about material things, chasing dollars and what have you? God is making us to remember that there is heaven. And if heaven is real, I tell you that hell also is real. Praise the Lord. So our hope and our target, our aim must be to make it to heaven. May God bless you.
Amen.
Whatsoever it is that will prevent you from making it to heaven, may God help you to take the right decision today.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. The family that our daddy had left behind, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We prayed for them last night. No prayer is too much. Let's pray for them. That the Lord will continue to guide them. Praise the Lord. Let me stretch for you. Stand in front here. I pray that the Lord, the hand of the Lord will be with them. The Lord will strengthen them. Whatever it is that need them to be accomplished or finished by Baba in his lifetime, God will use his children, his family to finish, to accomplish, to go the extra mile. The Lord God Almighty will keep them united. They will not sorrow, they will not carry the burden of sorrow or the loss of their loved one. The Lord God Almighty will continue to be your strength and be with them. Father, thank you for this wonderful family. Thank you, mighty God, for your strength and mercy upon them. I pray that, Lord, continually you will guide them. I pray that, Lord, they will never be confused. You always be their light and guide them, O God, in all your decisions, in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray for the unity of the family. We pray that your presence will continually be with them. And Lord, that you could bless and prosper the works of the heavens in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, precious Father. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Once again, I want us to put our hands together for the Lord, for Pastor Evans. Normally, I don't like addressing pastor like that, but we need to give honor to whom honor is due. I call him pastor, but that's last pastor. So it's very emotional and also important to Pastor Evans and the family. And we also want to appreciate you, sir, for all what you did for Papa when Papa was around.
I know that I said I'm one nodding, so I know the Spirit is leading me to say to you, sir, on behalf of Monarchy, we appreciate your family, sir. We love you. We pray that the Lord continue to strengthen you.
Amen.
And the Lord continue to keep you
in
the ministry and the entire family in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We are almost done. People used to say Nigerians don't keep to time. I don't believe that. But God was a strict advocate of time.
Yes.
Yeah, I remember those days, he would be waving at you. Just that you are a pastor of Jew, come to wave at you. So I'm going to invite Deacon Abodunde Okeke on behalf of the family to give an appreciation.
It has been announced. My name is Abodunde Okeke. Mrs. Olukunle is my sister. I just have two things to quickly say before I thank everyone. I'm encouraged today by the joining of the spirit that are here. Especially yesterday, it was repeated several times yesterday that Pa Ogunkunle drew his strength from the church. He drew his strength from the church. Let me just leave it there. The second thing that I want to say is that I'm really convinced, I believe, that he is actually resting in peace.
Yes.
You know, those people who are gone, like my brother just said, they always look back. They always look back before they finally go there. They always look back. Because they will be worried about their wife, about their children, about their loved ones. They will be worried. But it is time, like the pastors have already said, that we, the family, we need to let him go and rest by rejoicing, by praising, by telling him we are okay. And that's why we are here today. Therefore, because he has drawn his strength from the church, therefore he was not doing it alone. It is by the Spirit and the joining of hands of those who are around him. The pastors, the ministers, the friends, the neighbors. I saw some of the neighbors who are next door to them here today. That is the grace of God. Therefore, I'm thanking, I just wish to take this time to thank all the ministers, all the friends and families, on behalf of my sister and all the children, Lydie and family, Larry and family, Lakon and family, Lighton and family, and everyone who has contributed to a great life. Thank you.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We have come to the end of the service. I'm about to take the benediction. But we want to use this opportunity to thank everyone once again for coming. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
May the brethren of Resurrection of Life, Grace of Life, and from so many ministries and churches that we are friends of our daddy, your contribution and your efforts. Yesterday, I was so impressed. It was amazing what the Lord did. I want to thank God for everybody. For those that made this event to go very smoothly and be very successful. Praise the Lord. The Lord bless you. The Lord God Almighty will grant you your heart desires.
Amen.
You will not sorrow.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The Bible said that you shall not die but live to declare the works of the Lord.
Amen.
You will live.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And you declare the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living.
Amen.
Let us pray. We want to thank you, precious Father, for who you are. You are great and you do great things. Thank you for this occasion. Thank you for this program. Thank you for your children. Thank you for your people that have come to honor you, that have come to honor our daddy that have departed and that is now with you. I pray for each and every one of them that, Lord, you be with them.
Amen.
As they go home, you will go with them.
Amen.
As we go for the internment, Lord, you will finish it up there.
Amen.
Everything shall be successful.
Amen.
To the glory of your name.
Amen.
I pray, Father, mighty God, that you keep your people.
Amen.
And preserve them.
Amen.
Let it be well with them.
Amen.
The Lord says, say to the righteous, it shall be well with you.
Amen.
Declare unto your people today that it shall be well with them.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Divine protection, divine guidance, Lord, you shall give to them.
Amen.
Thank you, precious Father.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Minutes. So this last item, I want us to do rejoicing. I remember Mama keep telling me, my children, I want us to dance and celebrate. I know we are still going to dance when we get to the hall. We dance around her. Well, as we take this last year, this closing year, I want us to sing with all our heart, rejoice. Please let us rise. In two. It's supposed to be in three. Yeah, it's supposed to be in three. Okay. I'm pressing on the upward way. New heights I'm gaining every day. Still praying as I'm onward bound. Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. It is my prayer that the Lord will continue to keep the family,
amen.
Continue to plant their feet on higher ground,
amen.
And as many of us that have come to celebrate Baba, the Lord will continue to lift us higher.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In addition to our announcement, I want to announce the interment will take place by 12:30 p.m. National Army Memorial Park. We have the address and the pamphlet. You can put the address in the GPS to lead you through there. And also guest reception, courtyard by Marriott, Lincoln's Stroke Washington Banquet Hall, New Karoti Landover. Also, the address is there, 8330 Corporate Drive, Landover. We are expecting each and every one of us to come and finish the assignment. Amen. Lord, continue to bless us.
Amen.
God, continue to keep us.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Please let us go back to our seats. The casket is supposed to leave before everybody. Please, please, please. Hello. Please let us take our seats. Please let us come back to our seats. Please. Please.
Hold on.
Just for 2 minutes. It's part of the process. Thank you.
Those gentlemen that are designated pallbearers, we need you gentlemen to meet us out there on the lobby in the red carpet. For those gentlemen that are designated pallbearers, 6 gentlemen.
Those that will take the pallbearers.
When we leave you out, we're going to exit out with the pastor first, the casket, and then the immediate family should follow. In that order, off and right. There will not be no funeral stickers. We just go in the Harmony Cemetery, less than a mile up the street. So we won't pass out no funeral stickers. But as we exit out and go across Plano Road, 202.
Thank you.
www.ebbs.com.